So you want to know how to make a pigtail? Do you even know what one is? It's not that. It's not that either. Come on, I'll show you.
Electrical pigtails can be really useful, so let's go learn how to make one. All right, like in our other videos, we've got the navigation up top, you've got the overview, list of tools you'll need for the project, and of course, the project itself. Now over here, we've got these wires from where we pulled an outlet out of the wall, and they're really short. If you ever pull an outlet or a switch out of the wall and you've got short wires, knowing how to make an electrical pigtail can be really useful. That's what we're gonna show you right now. Now the tools that you're gonna need to do this, you're gonna need some pliers, wire cutters, strippers, you might need a utility knife. You should have had a tester to make sure that the power is off. Some wire nuts, or these push-in style connectors. Now safety first. I know if the wires are already out of the wall and there's no device, I can safely assume that, you know what, I'm not gonna assume. You know what happens when you assume? Make sure that the outlet or the switch that you're working with, that the power was shut off. You wanna go to your breaker panel, you wanna turn off the circuit, and make sure if you have your tester, push it in or turn it on, and then make sure that all of the wires are dead. Now, if there was still power, your tester should light up or make some noise. Now, really with a pigtail, all you're doing is you're taking a group of wires, you're clumping them together, and then you're having one long wire come off of it. So if you use these push-in connectors, you wanna make sure that you know how many wires are in the box. If you've got three wires coming into the box like I do, you're gonna wanna make sure it has at least four holes, because you need a spot for each of the three existing wires and then one for that long wire coming off. If you use the push-in connectors, it's pretty straightforward and explanatory how you push the wires in. I'm going to use the wire nuts and show you how to use those properly. The next thing you want to do is you want to actually separate your wires by color. So get all your black wires together, all your white wires together, and all of your copper ground wires together. So I've got some extra wire here. I'm actually going to take out so that I've got one of each. I've got a black wire, a white wire, and I've got this copper ground wire. Now in the box, as you can see, these wires are actually a different length. So what I'm gonna wanna do is I'm gonna wanna strip them so that they're the same length. And then clip them so that when I go to put my pliers on and twist, they're the same size. Now the wire that I'm gonna strip for the pigtail, I wanna strip and have the copper exposed about the same length as the wires that I have here on the wall. So one of the things that I see a lot of people do as a homeowner that's different from how an electrician would do is they put these wires together and then they just slip a wire nut over it and then they screw the wire nut on. Now, as an electrician, I was taught that I need to actually take these wires and I need to twist them together. You want to actually twist them clockwise. Now, the reason you go clockwise is because when you go to put on your wire nut, you're going to be screwing it clockwise. You want the wires to tighten in on each other. Now see how tightly those are together? So now, once I've got that done, I will normally clip off the end to make sure it's nice and straight and make sure that my wire nut's actually going to cover the exposed copper. And then I take the wire nut and I screw the wire nut on. Now, what I've got are all of my neutrals are together, and I've got this one wire that's much longer when I push these other wires back into the box. Now you can imagine how much easier this is to work with than trying to connect an outlet to these really short wires. So I'm going to go ahead and do that to the black wires and to the copper wires. So once the pigtails are made, you want to take all of your wires, fold them up like an accordion, push them in the back of the box. Now you've got wires that are plenty long to work with. Now you don't need excessive wires, so I usually come about 6 or 7 inches out of the box and clip them off. So my hand just happens to be the right size, so I'll take them and I will clip them off like that. And I'm ready to put in a new outlet. Just strip these, make fresh connections. Well, that's how you make an electrical pigtail. If you found this information helpful and informative, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. If there's anything else you'd like to know how to do when it comes to your electrical, plumbing, heating, or air conditioning system, leave your suggestions in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. We put a big subscribe button right there. That way, when you click it, you'll get notifications next time new videos come out. Have a great day. Thanks for watching.
Sun's out, guns out.
Oh, hi there. The button's right there. That way, you'll get notification when the video come out. Thanks for the day. What? Buffering? How short, you say? This short. It wasn't recording. You always miss the funniest stuff.